Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Factorio. I was working on my bus system last time, if I recall correctly. I had just finished making these assemblers for the lovely transport belts and was working on this side when I realized that the disparity between these two belts is going to cause some problems because the long-handled inserters and fast inserters move products at a different rate from each other. So it's going to cause a few issues trying to get both of these working at the same time if I'm pulling with different inserters, because I need three copper cables but only one piece of iron. So I'm going to have to mix this up a little bit differently than what I had before, but we should still, if I could speak, be able to get this working in quite an orderly fashion. I think what I'm going to do is kind of mix it up a little bit here. I'm going to go ahead and clear all this stuff out just to start from scratch. So let's grab all this crap here. Nom, 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 nom. Grabbing all this nonsense. Really cannot wait to get the sciencing started. So I'm falling behind on tech. I feel like I haven't touched the tech in a while, and I need to be researching that. So we're going to be focusing on the copper line as the sort of central area for this system. So let's extend this out a little bit. We definitely still want to give ourselves plenty of room, so we're going to do that. And I'm actually going to pull directly from this line like so. Grab some more fast inserters. There we go. Because I know for a fact that these things will eat up the copper very quickly. So you might be saying, well, what about the iron? Well, should be able to take care of that. We're going to sort of run a modified bus here with the iron coming in on the top side and the finished product going out on the bottom side. So let's see here. This may actually have been worked a little better if I'd flipped these around, but it'll be fine. So continuing this on, we'll have this here. Okay. Now I do need iron for both locations, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to split the iron right here. Actually, I'm going to split the iron, right here. There we go. I'm going to have to run this copper underground under the iron. Like so, okay, and we're going to move the iron down this way and up this way. I can expand this later if I need to, but for now this should work just fine. So now I have the iron splitting to both these directions. I do know for a fact from experience, and just for the sake of staying as loaded up on material as I can, that I will need more production for these, because you will go through a lot of them eventually. So we're gonna up the production right now, and I will actually, I think I'm going to extend these out a little further here. There we go. We're gonna need six more fast inserters. These will be placed here to also pull the copper. I'm hoping this one copper line can support these. There's a good chance I may need to double up the production of copper, even to the point where I'm putting out two buses of copper. It may even be that I can route a single bus of copper right up to here exclusively for these and then run the other one out there, but you know, those are considerations for a later time. So I'm going to go ahead and pull the products here. The iron should be able to be gathered at this rate. We'll find out for sure when we get this all set up with the power here. We do need to run the copper, of course, this way. There we go. So the copper is running, so both of those will be able to get it. And, of course, we need to find a way to actually drop the products off. So let's see about doing something like this. So those will be both dropping right here. Coming down this way, and then they'll be meeting up there. And there we go. And then I should be able to just do the same over here. I'm hoping that this will actually work out fine. These will actually join together in a reasonable pace. Although, you know what? There may be some issues. Let's test it. Rather than sitting here stroking our beards in thought, why don't we actually just give it a go? See what happens. I think we have everything connected here. Should be good. Oh. You know, it might help if I actually set the set the recipes to be crafted. That'd probably help. Looks like this is able to construct them quite, you know, it would actually help if I ran this belt underground here. That would be smart. There we go. Okay, so we're already kind of running into an issue here where it's messing up a little bit, but that may fix itself if we continue to draw the material in the right way. Actually, you know what we should do? So I should actually be running it like this. I should be running it like this. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to trim this out a little bit. I want to make sure that I'm not jamming these up and having any uneven distribution of product, because that is potentially very... it could be a very large hindrance here. And actually, you can almost already see that it looks like the copper is already not properly keeping up. So we're going to have to already up our copper production, but that should be fine. So anyway, switch these back around here and place this here. There we go. And a nice little trick, you can shift right click a building and then shift left click another building, and that will copy the production from one building to another, which is very nice. So there we go. So now we're going to be evenly distributing on the same sides of the belt, I hope. And actually, I'll just route this way for now. And I'll just run this under here. Yeah, we are going to need to up our production already, but that should be pretty straightforward. Let's make ourselves two more assembly machines. There we go. And I think I should be able to just place these side by side. It may be a little hard to get the power lines in here properly, but we should be able to do it. I'm just going to cut the power for a second here. And let's continue this line here. This line right here. I'm actually kind of wondering if this is also going to cause some disparity between each portion, but I guess we'll find out because of the different production rates. There we go. Now what I'm going to need to do is actually put some power here. So let's see here. Yeah, I should be able to do that. It's a little confusing, I know, but once you kind of understand how the mechanics for this game work, it's not too bad. It's not too hard to actually get the stuff organized how you want it. Just like before, we need to copy pasta the different products there. It looks like we're jammed up on only one side, and that may be just because we were rearranging everything here. We'll have to actually test this once I get the final product moving in the next phases of the next couple phases of the construction here. You know what? This looks really stupid. Let's see if I can fix this a little bit. It doesn't have to look super nice, but it is nice if it looks super nice. Can that reach? Oh, that's beautiful. It can reach. Nice. There we go. Much better. Now I can actually remove all this and have this a straight line again. Much, much, much prettier. I approve. Looks like we're running into some issues where some things are getting jammed up a little bit more. But it does seem to be pulling the products at least somewhat evenly. About as evenly as I could hope, I guess. Okay, I need to take a brief look here and see if there's any other sub-products I should be making before we can start making some final products. We're going to need copper plates and iron gear wheels for the science ones, and then we're going to need inserters and transport belts for the science twos. Let's see here, inserters, which take iron plates, iron gear wheels, and electronic circuits. So this is going to be an interesting one, trying to feed all these materials in where they're needed. Definitely leave some more room for some more of these, because it's likely we're going to need to produce a heck of a lot more of the electronic circuits at a later date. So for now, I'm going to move the... I'm going to make the transport and the construction of the inserters over in this area. So let's make a bunch more. Actually, let's grab a bunch of these since we're going to need them. There we go. And let's extend the buses a little bit. There we go. I suppose we are kind of going to run into the... you can see the problem here is that because of where these are being deposited, the priority for the construction is a little lopsided. Like, when the objects are being pulled evenly from this belt, it should be constructing using these two first, and then these two. Otherwise, it's going to be lopsided on one of the sides of the copper, because it's going to be pulling from both of these. So I'll mess with that in a little bit here. Let's just... I want to get science moving. I can work on optimizing these at a slightly later date, but I need to get the science up and running here. So, okay, let's see here. Gonna need to run three separate buses for the constructors for the inserters. Okay, so I need iron plates, iron gear wheels, and electronic circuits. Okay, so let's split the bus right here for the iron gear wheels. Make a couple more of these because we're going to need a lot. And we're also going to need the iron plates. We're going to need another couple splitters here. Okay, we need that underneath here, this underneath here. So there we go. So now those are both continuing on, which is good. The split should be coming through right here. Woo! Messing her up a little bit. There we are. And then we are going to need... Oh, it's getting a little dark. Let's, oh, there we go. There's the lights. Wonder if they're going to come on. And then I'm going to need to fork these right here. Like so. And I will need a few more underground belts. There we go. I believe all of our belts are intact on the bus. The wheels on the bus are going round and round indeed. And now we have all three of our initial items being brought in this way. So let's see if we can't hook these up in an easy configuration. I believe these are all used in an even distribution for their final product, which is the inserter. Looks like the electronic iron plate. Oh, you know what? I actually need the higher tier inserter for this, or the higher tier constructor, rather. Do I have access to that? No, I do not. So we're gonna have to remedy that. I have a little bit of science in here. Let's trying to jump ahead of myself and realizing that I actually can't do that. Not good. We need 80 science packs. One. Can I just make 80 of them? How long is that gonna take? Looks like a little while. We'll let those tick. All right, so let's go try to rearrange this again a little bit. It's very important that I maintain this sort of consistency. There's nothing more frustrating for me than watching only one side of a belt be pulled from. I need to make sure I'm pulling evenly and all that sort of stuff. So these two need to be placing the materials on the belt, the output belt, at the same time. So how can I do that? Well, I suppose one thing I could do would be to do this. This is a little weird, but it will do the job. Let those science packs finish here. Let me head over and drop off what I have. Get in there and science. So what this will be doing is this will be pulling the products at a slightly different rate from what they were before. Still pulling from the same line and then just allowing me to have the freedom here to move this wherever I need it. So what I can do is I can now run this line right here. Okay, so if you follow me here, the copper is now going under. I'm also going to have to replace this as well. There we go. And then we'll do the same thing here. That should work, I think. Oh, except this needs to be closer. There we go. Okay. So this will do the same thing, but now what this will allow me to do, if I rearrange this a little bit, is I can now, with a little bit of careful planning, actually insert both of these onto a line right here. Can this extend this entire way or no? It cannot. Okay, so we're going to have to do something slightly different with the iron here. This problem continues to vex me. Doesn't seem to be a very easy way for me to get the iron through. What if I do this? Let's try something here. Let's curve it up this way. So there we are. And let's get it turned in here as best we can. And you know what? We're just going to go ahead and clear all this stuff out. So I kind of need to redesign this. It's a big part of Factorio, really. It's getting all your designs to work fluidly and be replicatable and compact while being expandable. Really just trying to be the best damn factory designer you can be. That's the real trick. Oh, we're actually not making anything right now, so let's science some more science while we're sitting here rearranging things. In the meantime, I will head up here and continue to jam what science I have in here to continue researching automation 2, as we will be needing that very soon. Okay. So now I need to pull some really weird shenanigans. I need to run both the electronic circuit line and the iron line through this area here. So this could be a little bit of a challenge. So the output for this line is going to be right here. This is now the output, but I've got to be careful because you can see I need to run the copper underneath to get to further production over here. And likewise, this line has to be dropped onto by the other ones of these that I create in an even proportion. Again, the whole purpose of being so convoluted with this is so that the objects that I'm placing on the belts are always being taken off at the same rate, and then likewise we're placing objects on the next belts to be taken off at the same rate. So hopefully everything runs very smoothly. Hopefully, I guess, being the keyword. So let's see here. With the iron as it is, I'll need to run the iron down this way. So that's fine. I can manage that. Let's grab the other side of the copper. We'll grab that there, and then we're going to run the iron down here. And we need to connect this, of course. Get a little dark. Let's see if I can't drop a few lights in here. Lights, camera, action. There we are. So now I need to actually pull the iron off. And I guess I'm going to need to move these lights. So there we go. So now we're pulling iron again. And then there we're also pulling iron. And it looks like it's uneven, which of course it technically is for now, but I will be fixing that by placing these like so. So there we are, and now all I need to do is get the copper line also inputting from here. We need 4 more of these. Also gonna need some more sciences. Give me sciences. Back over and drop these off. I cannot wait to get the science automated, because that is the number one goal for the current insanely convoluted design here, is to get the sciencing started finally. So I'll be pulling the copper, and then I'm likewise going to be needing to drop the plot thickens. So I need to find a way to have both of these depositing onto the same line that these are depositing from. This is quite the conundrum I'm finding myself with. I do wonder if I'm trying to be too compact with this, and if I should just be running these a lot more wild than I already am. You know, maybe if I have cut the iron line through the middles and the actual processor lines on the outside. Makes me very happy to know that I can't just immediately solve these problems, even though I've played through this game before. Always important to challenge yourself when you're doing this sort of thing. Let's see here. What if I... There's got to be some way to do this. There has to be some way to do this. The thinking is real. One thing I will definitely need is two more of these to actually insert those objects. Head over and drop off some more science. Good old red potions of science plus one. There we go. Okay, so these will be placing onto the middle, ideally. Right here. So you can see that's going to cause some problems. If I route it like this, which is what it's supposed to be, now I'm going to have too much trouble trying to get the copper where it needs to be, which is right here. You can see doesn't quite make it. But this does have to be one continuous line, otherwise it's not going to deposit the products correctly. So we're at a little bit of a crossroads here, where I need to have each of these bordered by three different items in a way that makes sense. In a way that I can expand horizontally if I need to over here. Iterations upon iterations, ladies and gentlemen. Iterations upon iterations. Okay. I like the idea of running the copper down the middle. I really do, but I also really like the idea of pulling the material and putting them back on a belt heading this way. So what if... I wonder if I could somehow make this central transport belt holding these things. I wonder if I could actually make this run this way somehow. Like run in the middle going opposite to the copper lines. Seems kind of unlikely, doesn't it? That would be possible. Seems pretty unlikely. And I'm still, you know what, I'm actually still running into the same problem here because I'm evenly pulling the copper, but I am not evenly pulling the iron. So there's got to be some other way to do this. I think we might need to do another iteration of this. This is just not quite solving the problem. Hey, we're getting there on the automation. That'll be nice, so I can finally get some sciencing automated. Because the problem, as I mentioned, is that the fast inserters move more quickly than the long-handed inserters, and I know for a fact that these things absolutely eat up copper cables, and there's no way I can have one side competing with the other without an even amount of inserters going into either side. That is a problem that I know I'm going to have. But I also need to solve the problem of pulling all of these products off evenly while also pulling the products in completely evenly. So the only thing I can think of to otherwise do this would be to implement a similar feature as what I have right now and almost do like a DNA helix type thing, which sounds kind of weird. But essentially have these three lines twisting around, competing for the assembly machine's loyalty and favor. If you know what I mean. All right, here we go, guys. Iteration number three. This is sciencing 101 in the game of Factorio. Trying to make things nice and even and productive as much as you can. Well, if anything, I'm getting a lot of these materials in my inventory. It makes it easier to craft things by hand if I need to. Always look at the bright side, I suppose. All the tasty, tasty products. I don't mind overproducing and even having a million of these on my person because of how frequently they are used. Because spoiler alert, it's quite frequently that these are used. Quite a frequent occurrence. Okay, so the only thing I'm certain of is that I need to be pulling the copper off like this. We're just going to, just for the sake of simplicity, we are going to pull these like this. Okay. Now the iron. This is where things get a little hairy. Because what I would like to do is, and if I have to, I will just use these, which is fine by me. Okay, I can do this, and then I need to have these pulling iron. So let's see if I can get the iron line in here evenly while still having the copper line available. Let's see about doing something like this. Yeah, there we go. See what I mean by sort of snaking it? That could work. That could actually work. So this goes under to there. So now the copper is going to be pulled off evenly, and these are going to be pulled off evenly, and then I need to actually place the finished product onto the finishing line evenly, which is also going to be weaving in and out of here. So I'm going to have to do a similar maneuver here with this line. So they need to deposit here. This is sort of the start, so I can kind of wiggle a little bit with this one here. I think that'll work. And we will pull it out this way. And then you know what I'm thinking? This is what I'll do. I will actually have these backwards for now, just because I want to get this project finished, this part of the project finished at least. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to drop another underground belt right here. There we go, all the way to here. Perfect. I know it looks a little weird, but this will actually work. And then I need to have one of these here. I will need to expand this at a later date, but that is a problem for future Cil. I'm kind of running out of time on this episode, and I want to try to get this at least in a working order of some sort before I sign off. Grab some more of these. So let's see here. So I guess the next goal is to have the iron weave its way around here. So let's do that. Let's get the iron underneath here. Okay, so it's weaving under that way. And then I can curve it around this way and I can weave it back in. So the copper needs to go here and here. That will take care of the copper needs. The iron needs to weave up through this way. So I may actually be able to continue this sort of weaving pattern fairly easily. Can this actually extend even further? I think it can. Can this extend all the way to here? It can. That's beautiful. So yeah, I can actually use a weaving system for this. That'll work quite nicely, actually. So now it's extendable, because now you can see what I'm doing here is I have these like this, weaving in and out of the area and being deposited to, if it makes even the slightest bit of sense. And then I can have this line going out here. And I will actually just have this meet up this way. Instead, it's not quite as pretty, but it will work. There we are. We have more sciencing. Let us go away and turn the sciencing in. bam. That should be enough for automation too, and I can finally finish those up. Let's get these powered here. Interesting thing is if you have these that are sort of passing in between each other, you can actually put an object on there as long as it doesn't interfere with the progress, and it'll actually allow you to move the materials through that object. So you can see I have two inserters very blurrily going through each other. Having an electric pole here doesn't affect that. Woo! That's what I needed. I needed the assembly machine too. Needed it very dearly. I will be working on better electric energy distribution here soon. For now, I have to stick with the old wooden poles. And they're there. And this here. There we go. And this needs to curve around like this. And I think we're in good shape. Oh, these are the wrong way. There we go. Now, assuming I've done everything properly, all of the devices should be getting the same products in at the same time. Let me let these get completely caught up, because right now it's not acting evenly, but that's because I had to turn them on at different stages there. Now let me grab a bunch of these and see how that handles that. Seems we handled it pretty well, actually. You can see it's nicely producing the products at a very even rate, and it's pulling the copper in at a very even rate, which is also still looking like it's getting bottlenecked at a very even rate. Yeah, we are not producing enough copper again, but that's okay. That is a problem for another time. Probably very soon, but another time. As I stated, there's a very good chance, especially if I don't have the faster conveyor belts, that one single line of these will not be enough to keep up, because of the insane amount of copper that's actually used here. But the thing is I'm actually completely emptying this line when I do these tests, and the likelihood of me actually burning that many of these circuits is pretty slim. So nothing really to be worried about. I think this episode went a little bit long, but that's okay. We learned a lot of fun stuff. And I think we finally have made a working setup using the sort of weaving system. It's good to remember that for the circuits. So I will see you guys next time on the Factorio LP. Thank you for watching. My name is Cilantro. Have a good night.